Hey, high levelers, Rayo Daniel here, and I want to bring another small feature, just one little small additional feature that Highlevel has had for probably a year, maybe even 2 years, that I have noticed coming out and being updated and updated to the point where it's actually become quite robust, and that's QR codes. Now, QR codes aren't really anything that you're going to sit back and build a business around, but they're something that can really help benefit your clients, and I want to sit back and at least create this video. It's not going to be very long. A couple of minutes just to show you some of the updates and features, because personally, I think some of the features that Highlevel has added with the QR codes are pretty fantastic, pretty easy to configure. And I just want to make sure that everybody knew about them so that if you have a client out there that may need these services, then maybe adding QR codes would be a great benefit that you can give them on top of what you're already selling them. Yep, maybe even just as a bonus for being a great client. Let's hop in and take a look. Okay, so right now we're going to go to the QR codes area, which is going to be under the sites area. So here on the left-hand menu, we're going to go to sites, and then at the very top here, we've got QR codes. Now, QR codes, like I said, for the most part, have been around for quite a bit. Now, Highlevel started, just a little history, Highlevel started QR codes back with regards to reputation management. They created them so that you can have QR codes for generating a Google review and things like that. They've started to take that idea and get and expand on it to the point where now they have a lot of different QR code types. I remember when they first came out, I had a lot of my affiliates ask you about the QR code feature, specifically if it has like website information or things like that, or even if you could do like a business card or something like that and have all of your business information just within a QR code. And at the time, Highlevel didn't have that feature, but now they do. I've just been noticing as Highlevel has been sending out updates, and as I look at all these new updates that keep coming out, I'm like, man, this QR code is becoming really cool, really powerful. Let me create a video, let everybody know what's going on. So let me hop in here and just kind of show you. This is the QR code area. You can just simply say create QR codes. Now, I want to just take a minute and I'm not going to go over all of these like in detail. We are going to go over some of them. But right now, if we take a look, these are the options that you get. Website. Again, there's always the review link for Google reviews, but now there's call, SMS, email. If you want to have a payment option, if you want to send people to just be able to sit back and make a payment through you, you can send them a payment link through this. And that could be on invoices and things like that. WhatsApp. Forms, but more importantly, I thought was pretty cool are these profile cards, VCards, and then business cards. So I'm going to be taking a look at several of these and we're going to be looking how easy it is to configure these. And then some of the more complicated ones like the profile card and the VCards. One of the things I want to point out is the name right here. Please make a note of that. Right now, I'm not sure if this is a bug or if this is something that Highlevel hasn't created yet, but if you want to name something, here is the time to name it. And the reason I say that is because once you create a QR code, it cannot be renamed. Not that I've ever been able to try to figure out. There's not an edit rename. You can't go into the properties and rename it. So if the QR code is left, I'm going to just leave the name like this on this example so I can show you what I mean. But just make sure you name it, because if you don't, you might have to recreate it and then rename it again in order to utilize it. But keep in mind, whenever you generate a QR code, okay, please make sure you're going to continue to use that, because if you change the QR code, even slightly, even if you regenerate the same thing over and over again, the QR code could be different. The actual image and dots and stuff like that may be a little bit different. So anyway, right now, just to show you some of the ease of the interface, I'm just going to do a basic one for a website. So this particular website, you click on it and we're going to go ahead and click next. Notice we're going to get additional information. I'm just going to do google.com just to make it easy. And then I'm going to sit back and go to next. Now, here's one of the things that's really nice. If you take a look over here to the right, this little QR code, you do have some options of customizing this. Now, let me just take a quick step back here. I remember wanting to do this years and years ago with some clients, generating QR codes for Google reviews or generating QR codes that people can put like on the side of their car that maybe goes to their website or something like that. I know a lot of realtors have begun utilizing these, real estate agents start utilizing QR codes so that people could just scan it, pop it up, and just go somewhere. Right now, if you're doing that, it's really nice to customize it. Rather than just sit back and have to just take what you're given, it's nice to customize it. And at the time, a couple of years ago, I remember that there are some sites that allow you to build stuff for free. Other stuff that was just very limited, didn't allow you to customize it, or you had to pay for a subscription plan. I just think it's really nice that Highlevel included this new feature so that you can give it to every client if they want to put QR codes on their business cards, if they want to leave review cards at the end of the job, or they leave a review card with a QR code that goes to the Google review. That would be a great option. Or VCards, all these type of things are great options that you can have that basically, in a sense, are free to you. All you have to do is implement them for the client, and I think they might find it very, very worthwhile. Specifically, if you're dealing with people that have a service business where they come in to the business a lot, you can have a little plastic stand that has leave us a Google review and have a QR code right there for leaving a Google review right there. So that right there is a great way to sit back and enhance and allow the business to get more Google reviews right at checkout. But let's take a look here. Right now we see we got background color. We can change it if we wanted to. I'm just going to choose some weird colors here to show you what's going on. I will do green. Oh, that's really hard on the eyes right there, isn't it? We'll do blue there for this color, and then come over here and do some kind of purple. So notice those colors are all bright, the reds and everything else blend together. But all I'm trying to say is that you can customize this to whatever you want. And you can sit back and even customize it more with some of the shapes. If you wanted to have different shapes for these, you can just simply turn these on. You can simply have a circular. These little things in the corner here, you can have square, rounded edges. If you want to have the centers to be circular or square, you can customize it, which is a good thing. If you wanted to, you could put a logo in the middle of it. So if this is something that matches right here, you could simply put Google. If this is like a Google review, for instance, you could just stick Google right in the middle. That red is an awful background. I think it's kind of hurting my eyes here, but just not me. There we go. Just something a little bit different. But anyway, thought maybe you'd be able to see Google a little bit better, but you see the point. You can actually create a logo and put that here if you want to, and even put a background image if you want to. So come here, select. Let me see what I got here. I'll just use a high level image. So you can even put that in the background if you want to. And then once you do that, now it's complete. You can simply download it as a PNG, SVG file, or PDF, however you want to do that. But now you can simply click save. And now that QR code can be used. And as long as you don't delete it, that QR code will now be pointing to wherever you want it to do. Now, if you ever update that, this is where it comes in. You got to be careful, because if this QR code is deleted, then everything that you created that QR code off of is going to be invalid. A QR code won't work and you need to regenerate it. So that's why I'm saying you might want to do something like come over here and start creating folders. These folders could be just, let's just call it this or something like that. So if you want to do, I have a folder for business, you can move this into a particular folder here and say, okay, so anything in the business folder, we don't want to sit back and mess with, because those are things that we're actively utilizing. All the other things we might put into like a draft folder or something like that, or just leave it here at the root. Either way, just be careful is all I'm saying. Now, here's one of the things I did notice that I want to bring up to you here is, notice that this QR code, I've tried like multiple times to like, to see if I could delete this or come in, and if notice on here, there's no rename feature. There's just a delete. If I come in here, I can edit the features here. But notice here, even if I come back to the previous screens for these, I can't really change the name of it here. So that's why I'm just like, okay, it doesn't give me the name screen anymore. It does allow me to customize it. So just be careful. If you do want to name it, make sure you name it before you actually save it. Otherwise, you're going to end up recreating it. So that's all. Now, some of the other things I thought was pretty cool about this one here are, you've got all these cool things that you can do. Specifically, except it's another great one. If you want to sit back and if you have a business that is specifically outside the US that utilizes WhatsApp a lot, I've been traveling and I see a lot of WhatsApp QR codes specifically on Windows and things like that, so that click on it and actually automatically create a chat with the business or join a particular WhatsApp group or something like that. But that's something that you can do as well. Now, some of the other things I'm just going to show you on this one, I'm not going to create these, are things like these form survey and quizzes. If you wanted to sit back and actually have a form that's just like, hey, you're going to do a giveaway and you just want somebody to submit a form, say, hey, go to this particular form, fill it out, and I'm going to ship you something for free or email you something. Then you can just simply click on the form. Next, here's a nice thing. You can allow it to choose whatever form that you've already created on there to do that. And then just simply click next, choose all the colors, and you're done. So it's really just that quick, that easy, just how quickly you can get this stuff done and create these for your particular customers. And you probably only have to create a couple, three, four, five or something like that for their particular needs. And then just save them. And then once they're saved, then you know they can continue utilizing those over and over again, collecting leads and things like that. Now, one of the things I do want to show you that I think is pretty cool is these profile cards. So notice right here, I'm going to blow this up a little bit here. Notice I got Steve Jobs right here, his famous, infamous Steve Jobs photo. But this right here is, you know, it's more just like a link that you would put out like a social media page, like you're making a public contact information. I'm not going to say Linktree, for example, exactly, because this just has contact information or stuff like that, but it has some basic information, and this card information is actually stored inside of Highlevel. It's actually stored inside the QR code information whenever it gets displayed. So that's where it's stored out here. It's not external or anything like that. And as far as I know, I've tried to create these and edit them, but anyway, it's pretty cool. You just simply put in your phone number. I'm going to go ahead and click next and just kind of show you this right here. If we want to change the background screen, maybe to a little bit of a darker blue, I'll make it look more professional. Put in your name, Rayo Daniel. You can upload an image file if you want to. This is one that I just did here. I just wrote one off my bucket list here and went skydiving, which is like pretty awesome, pretty cool. Doing 150 mile an hour free dive from a plane at 10,000 feet. Nothing gets the blood pumping like that. That's my image that I took from the video. You can do transparencies. Make it transparent if you want to. But you get a lot of other options is my point here. All the website information. If you want to put an address for your business, notice right here, you've got all these other ones. If you want to create your socials for TikTok, YouTube, all the ones that you could put here and make it available. And then all you have to do is present the QR code, post it someplace, and then now you can make it available for people to come up and have your information. Now, But keep this in mind. The profile card right now is just that. It is a profile card that gives information about you. But what it doesn't do, it doesn't allow you to save it. So this is where the VCard comes in. This is where the VCard comes in nice and handy, because the VCard, if you ever heard of it, like virtual card, I think I might be wrong about that, but just this is where you can actually give people a link and then they can download your information as a contact on their phone. So this is where it becomes very good. I know there's a lot of just cards out there rather than giving physical cards anymore. They've got these like cards that you tap or stuff like that, and then it pops up and gives the information and you click save and download. That's available too. But it's just pretty cool that you have this available and can utilize this. But again, just doing the VCard, you're just putting in the same type of information, uploading an image with all of your company contact information. And now you can just present the QR code. They scan the QR code, click on it, boom, download the VCard. They open it up and click save or create new contact, something like that. And now all your information is right there on their phone. If you don't put anything in here, you don't want to share with other people. So that's pretty cool. And then just the business card. If you want to typically have the business card that has all your information on it, then this is what you can do here. And again, there's slightly different choices. This has business hours on it. The other ones didn't. And these have socials on it too. So it is a little bit different, but I just thought it was at least worthwhile. It's pretty cool that if you wanted to, you could offer this to your clients. You could say, hey, do you have a website? Do you want to, is there anything right here that you want to put like a call button somewhere on, maybe on the front part of your, you know, on your office or your business place? Things like that. So all of these things become available and you can just utilize them just all as part of the Highlevel platform. So anyway, that's all I had. Just a quick video just regarding some of the new features. I did think this was pretty cool that has all of these different options that you can have in here for your clients. So if you thought it was cool, hit the like button. Leave me a comment if you have any questions. If you have not subscribed, click the subscribe button, smash to that bell so you get these videos every time I come out. I do publish a couple times a week. And thanks so much for hanging in with me and have a great day. Bye-bye.